In this video, I'm gonna show you how to download and install WinGx software. First, let me tell you how to download this WinGx software from the internet. Let's go to the Google Chrome. After opening Google Chrome, just type WinGx WinGx download. Or else WinGx program system, if you type, you will get a website like this, WinGx program system. Here, the current version of WinGx may be downloaded here. If you click on to this, you will get a software like this, WinGx version 2018. You can download this and supporting ORTEP, Platoon, everything can be downloaded from here. Before downloading, we must get the license from them. This is free of cost for academic and scientific, educational and non-commercial users only. So, as for the academic purpose, you can able to download for free of cost. So, we must get the license. If you are working in any college or university, it is a free of cost for you. So, just click on the license button here. After clicking license button, here they have shown that please click here to submit license request. Just click on to this. After clicking this, we must select the WinGx program or ORTEP 3, anything we can select. I'm just clicking WinGx here. Next, whatever the version you are using, Windows 10 or 8, based on that, you must click on to this. Afterwards, type your name and email. Next, affiliation, the college or university, wherever you are working, company or organization, etc. You just enter here and then submit license request, and they will mail you the license keys to your email ID. The license will be like this. They will be sending you just a mail like this. They will be sending you a mail like this. You will be having a mail. You will get a mail like this. This is the license file. Afterwards, download. After getting the license, just download the download this current version of WinGx, may be downloaded from here. Just click on to this here. You will get a WinGx version released on 5th October 2018. Just click on to this. It will get downloaded. You can see here it is around 28.99 MB. Just click on to the start download, as I have already downloaded. I'm just cancelling this. Just minimize this. And then click on to this. Here, this is a file we can able to get from, which I have shown there. I have downloaded this earlier, so I am showing here. Just extract this. It will be sending you in a form of this will be downloaded in a form of a zip file. Just extract this. After extracting, you will get a folder like this. Here it is a setup file. Just install this by clicking onto the run as administrator. Run as administrator. I'm just running it. I'm installing. Now the software is being installed. Just I accept agreement. And here they will be giving you some instructions. Next, everything you next, and the desktop icon, create it. Uninstall everything here. You ready me launch WinGx. Okay, after installing, it will show a window like this. It will ask you to enter license details. Just click the enter license details and go to the license file. And I'm just opening WinGx license file here. Just copy those all the things. This is my license file, don't use this. I'm just copying all the license files and application details and Windows version. Everything that you can give here, just give OK. Afterwards, we need to give our details, wherever we are working, our name, everything we need to fill out here. Thank you. you want, you can give your official address, everything if you want. I'm just clicking OK here. Okay, now it is being opened. Project working directory, project ID, everything will get opened here. If you want to just here, what we need to open is you need to browse .ins file. INS file only opened here. Just go to browser and click on the crystal data and select INS file. INS means instruction file. Thus, data you will be getting from the crystal XRD data. I'm just cancelling it. Before running, you must choose some variable. You need to change some environment variable in your system, then only it will run fast. These are the environment variable I am showing here. WinGx environment directory we need to change, and pg font environment directory we need to change. Next, if you want to install ORTEP, for ORTEP also we need to change the environment variables here. How to change these environment variables? Let me show you now. For changing environment variable, just go to search button, just type VARI variable, edit environment variable for your account. Just click on to this. If you are using Windows 7 also, the same thing you need to type in the search button. You can able to get the environment variables for your account. Just click on to that. Up, you will get a window like this there. Now what you will do is just click on to the new button. In that it will ask you variable name and variable value. There what you need to do, this is the name WINGXDIR. This is the name of the variable. Just copy and paste that. Afterwards, that path of the variable in the C drive, WinGx. This is the path of the variable. I am setting that. Okay, just click on to that. Okay, you will get a variable here. See here. And next, set the second one, that is PG font. This also we need to set. Then only we can able to run the program. Otherwise, we cannot able to run the program. Just click the location. Environment variable value is this PG font. Just click on to this. Okay. This has been added here. PG font has been added here, and WinGx DIR has added here. Next, let me set for ORTEP 3 also. ORTEP 3 if I want to give the ORTEP 3, I need to see the directory for the ORTEP 3 also. First, let me install ORTEP also. Now I have given WinGx directory variables. Okay, now let me install ORTEP also. ORTEP software, let me install. Shown you, let me download from there itself. From here you can able to download ORTEP version 2014 version. I'm just clicking onto this. It is just 1.89 MB. I'm just downloading here now. Okay, it has been downloaded in the form of a zip file. I'm just cutting this and pasting out here. Okay, extract this ORTEP file. Okay, ORTEP 2014 version has been extracted. Just run the setup as an administrator settings. Okay, click on to the next. Give okay agreement, accept the agreement, everything. Okay, here they have given, you can see here. In order to ORTEP 3 Windows to work, the environment variable must be set. If you won't change this environment variable, it never run. ORTEP will not run. So what we need to do, we need to set up the environment variable as I have said for WinGx software. Click the next. Give anything whatever you want. Some organization, Windows user, something whatever you want, whatever your name, you can give your name. and your organization name. Yes, click on to the next. Next. Okay. Yes. Next. Here desktop icon, launch icon. Next, install. Finish. It will show you installation directory like this. Here, these are the things we need to set now. After running the setup, program will need to set the environment variables. Variable name is this, and we need to set the variable name as the pull path where the ORTEP 3 is present. So now what we'll do? Just set up that environment variables, then only it will open. Without setting environment variable, if you open this, how it will show? Let us see. It will show you like this. You need to set the environment variable. It is showing this. The environment variable of ORTEP 3, the IR, is not defined. If you set the environment variable, then only it will open. Otherwise, it will not open. So what we do? We need to set up the environment variable here. Let me set up the environment variable for ORTEP 3. How to set up this? Just go to the set icon again, which we have done for WinGx software. Just type VARI variable, edit system variables. Just click on to the system variable. Here, these are not the system variables. We need to select the environment variables, VARI variables, edit environment variable for your account. Here, just go to the new button and then type ORTEP DIR. This is the name of the variable, and variable value should be the full path of the installation directory of ORTEP 3. The full path we need to give. This will be at a C drive. So I'm just copying the C drive. This will be present at the location of C drive. So I'm just copying that. See the in the C drive where it is. Let us see. I'm just opening my computer here. Let's go to the PC. Here Windows 10 I'm using. Go to the C drive. Here let us see where the ORTEP 3 is. Here it is in the C drive. It is in ORTEP 3 name. So just rename that. Copy. I'm just copying that name, the same name which they have given in C drive. I'm just pasting out here. Control V. I'm just giving variable name is in C drive ORTEP 3 name. Just click on to the OK. Then it is set. Now if you open, it will get to open. Once you can check it, ORTEP 3. It is not still opened. You need to give the full path of the directory. Set again VARI variable, edit system variable, not the system variable, it is a environmental variable. Environmental variable, click on to the new button on the ORTEP DIR, ORTEP 3 DIR, ORTEP 3 DIR, full path of the installation. Let's go to the C drive. Onto the OK. Okay, here it is there. Okay, okay. Now let us try whether it will open or not. It is showing some okay. Now it is being opened. Just click OK. Okay, now it is over, I think. Then when variable set to the all the values. Now we need to enter the you need to enter the license details of it. License details you need to enter. Need to enter the license details. I'm just entering license details. Where the license details are, let me see. So the license details. ORTEP license. This is my ORTEP license. Just give all the details which they will send you through mail. They will send you through mail. You select the license number also. And Windows version, I'm just selecting Windows 7. Give OK. Now we have entered the license details. Let's close it. That's it. You will be getting ORTEP software like this. This is a licensed version. Now it has become a licensed version. Again, open on C. Now it won't ask any license details or anything. Never run. The interaction and anything it won't run directly. It will open. If you want, you can here which type of files we can open here. Here we can able to open .res file, residual files only we can able to run here, and zip file also we can see the structure of that. Okay, now everything is clear. I think I'm just testing this WinGx software also. I'm just opening. Okay, now it is opening. It is asking the file directory. Everything is working fine. Okay. Please subscribe to my channel. In my next video, I'm going to show you how to solve crystal structure using this WinGx software. Please, if you want to follow my updates, please click on to the subscribe and click the bell icon. Thank you. Thanks for watching.